In this video, we look at the playlists in Naxos Music Library. This page shows you all the playlists that you have access to in Naxos Music Library. At the top of the screen, you can select the playlists that you have created, but also built-in NML playlists, themed playlists, and if you're using NML through an institution, like a college or a library, you will also see a link to their playlists here. We've created a sample institution, NML Tutorials. In My Playlists, you have a list of folders on the left-hand side, which helps you organize playlists once you have more than a few. Click the plus icon next to Folders to open the new folder dialog. Enter a name here, and if you like, an author and remarks. The tab list is available for institution administrators who can make shared playlists. Click Save to create the folder. In my study folder here, I have two playlists on the right. The first thing you can do here is quickly create a new playlist. Click the Create Playlist link. In the dialog box, use the sequence number to say where you want the new playlist to show in the list. If you don't select anything, it will be added at the bottom. Add a playlist name and optionally an author and remarks. Let's type arias and then click Save Playlist. Our new playlist is added at the bottom of the list. The next link is Move Playlist. Select one or more playlists and then click Move Playlist to move it to another folder. I've selected our Arias playlist. Now click Move Playlist and selected Home. Two really useful features, especially in an educational context, are the import and export functions. You can export any number of playlists to an XML file, which you can then import into a different account. This is one easy way of sharing playlist information between users. Once you have a few playlists, you might like to reorder them. This is really easy to do here. In my Home folder, I now have three playlists. Just click the title of a playlist and drag it to a new position in the list. Click Yes to confirm. It couldn't be easier. There's another way to do this, which we'll look at now. Next to each playlist, on the right-hand side, is an edit icon. When you click it, you'll be able to edit the sequence position of the playlist, and also any other information like the name, author, and remarks. Finally, there's a trash icon next to each playlist. This will delete that playlist. You can also select one or more playlists and click the trash can icon at the top right to delete them. Let's now have a look at some of the contents of a playlist. Click the title of the playlist to open it. On the left, you'll see details about the playlist, with the title, the sequence number, author and remarks, the number of tracks, the total timing of the playlist, the tab, and the folder it's contained in. On the right-hand side, you'll see the contents of your playlist. At the top, you'll see the name of your playlist, and on the right, a play button. This is the quickest way to start listening to the tracks in the playlist. You can also select individual tracks from the playlist and then click play. This will then start playing just those tracks. You can also play just a single track by clicking the small play button next to each track. In the playlist contents view, click the plus icon next to the title to show more details about a track, with a thumbnail and the title of the album, work name and the performers, and a link to jump straight to the album page. Apply Alias is a really good way of keeping track of recordings you might be working on. You can add an alias which will be displayed in place of the original title. You can still always see the original details behind the track by clicking the plus button. Just like in the playlist folder view, you can delete single tracks here by clicking the trash can icon at the end of each line. You can also select more than one track and click the trash icon here. Finally, here too, it's really easy to reorder tracks in a playlist. Just click the track and drag it to the desired new position in the playlist. That's a brief overview of the playlist functionality in Naxos Music Library. See our other tutorial videos for more details.